mathematicians, it's Justin again, and welcome back to the Miaville Adventure Park. We've been using my new analog watch to practice telling the time. There's one very important show that I've been trying to get to all day, the Miaville Talent Show. You may remember from the last lesson that the 11 o'clock show was canceled and we missed the 12:33 show. Fortunately, there's one more show at 5:17. It's a little bit after 1 o'clock right now, and I want to fill my afternoon with lots of fun activities, but I don't want to miss the 5:17 show. Too bad my phone battery died or I just set an alarm. I still have the map and the park schedule though. So how could we use these items to make sure we get to the show on time? I'm thinking we can build our own schedule for the afternoon. We'll get to enjoy everything Miaville Adventure Park has to offer and see the talent show. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to figure out what time an event will end. You'll also be able to identify how much time will pass from the start to the end of an event. Have your guided notes ready, and let's get planning. This is where the talent show is happening, but I just walked to the other side of the park to be closer to the ropes course. Let's figure out how long it took me to walk here so we'll know how long it will take to walk back later. It was 1 o'clock when I started walking over here. What time is it now? The hour hand is still within the 1 o'clock hour. Then we can count by fives to start figuring out the minute. 5, 10, 15, 20. Counting on by ones then helps us figure out the exact minute. 21, 22. That means it's 1:22. So I started walking at 1 o'clock, and now it's 1:22. How long did it take for me to get across the park? 1 o'clock is the start of the hour, and 1:22 is 22 minutes into the hour. That means it took me 22 minutes to get here, and will probably take me 22 minutes to get back. Knowing when something starts and when something ends can help us figure out the elapsed time. This is the amount of time that passes between the start and end of an event. Sometimes the schedule will list the elapsed time, like how the talent show is 45 minutes long, or how the Ferris wheel takes 6 minutes. And some events have the elapsed time and a start time listed, like the ropes course. I have a pass that lets me start the ropes course at 1:30 and climb for 1 hour and 15 minutes. But it doesn't give me the end time. If I know what time it ends, then I can pick the next activity for my schedule. If we know the start time and the elapsed time, how can we figure out the end time? The pass starts at 1:30 and lasts for 1 hour and 15 minutes. It may be helpful to break this up into chunks. So what time will it be 1 hour after 1:30? Well, the minute hand will do a full rotation, moving the hour hand 1 hour forward. So 1 hour after 1:30 will be 2:30. And then we need 15 minutes more. We don't need to do a full rotation, we can just count 15 minutes more from 2:30. Pause here to figure out the end time for the ropes course and record that on the schedule in your guided notes. Moving forward from 2:30, 5, 10, 15 minutes brings us to 2:45. So my pass starts at 1:30 and ends at 2:45. Let's see what other activities we can fit in before the talent show. I'll be leaving the ropes course at 2:45. And while I'm still on this side of the park, I want to check out the virtual reality zone. There's a really cool VR space tour that starts at 2:55. It's right next to the ropes course, and there's a snack stand between them. You think I'll have enough time to buy a quick snack between the end of the ropes course at 2:45 and the start of the tour at 2:55? Pause here to record your thinking in your guided notes. First, we need to figure out how much time is between 2:45 and 2:55. Both times are in the 2 o'clock hour, and 45 and 55 are just 10 minutes apart. Since everything is close by, 10 minutes should be enough time to buy a quick snack. Perfect. So far, I have the ropes course from 1:30 to 2:45, or 1 hour and 15 minutes, a snack from 2:45 to 2:55, or 10 minutes, and then the VR space tour from 2:55 to 3:40. Wait, what's the elapsed time for that? Pause here to figure out how long the tour is in your guided notes. We can use a visual model like this clock to help us skip count. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45. Or notice how 2:55 is only 5 minutes away from 3 o'clock? Since it ends at 3:40, we could take those 40 minutes from the 3 o'clock hour and add them to the 5 minutes here, giving us a total of 45 minutes. A 45-minute VR space tour? Cool. I wonder what else is on this side of the park. Ooh, there's an arcade over here too. The VR tour will be over at 3:40, and the talent show is at 5:17. So how much time will I have between the end of the tour and the start of the talent show? Pause here to find the elapsed time in your guided notes. 3:40 plus 1 hour is 4:40. If we add another hour, what time would that be? 5:40, and I'd miss the talent show. So let's count on from 4:40 until we get to 5:17. We can skip count like earlier. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 36, 37. Or notice how there's 20 minutes until the 5 o'clock hour and the show starts at 5:17. We can add 20 and 17 and also get 37. That means it's 1 hour from 3:40 to 4:40 and 37 minutes from 4:40 to 5:17. That's a total of 1 hour and 37 minutes to play at the arcade. Oh, no, wait, travel time. It's a 22-minute walk from this side of the park, and I don't want to miss the talent show. So I'm going to play it safe and only do 1 hour at the arcade, which means I'll head back around 4:40. So, what have we learned today besides the fact that I'm going to make it to the talent show on time thanks to the schedule we built today? Well, now you know that elapsed time is the amount of time that passes between the start and end of an event. Using the start time and elapsed time can help you figure out the end time for an event. You also know elapsed time can be figured out by counting the hours and minutes in between a start and end time. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice working with elapsed time. Remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, practice makes progress. Thanks for helping me build this schedule today. Now, it's almost 1:30. Time to head to the ropes course. I'll see you next time. Hey.